They've been called the greatest generation. World War II has become their hallmark. That mantle of recognition is theirs because of what they fought against, what they fought for, but mostly because of what they stood for. 16 million of them, men, women, many only 17 years old, put their families, their lives, their dreams on hold to fight a war in the name of freedom and liberty. They came home victorious those oh so many years ago against a powerful tyrannical enemy. But now, today, as with all full lives well lived, age, even with its badge of honor, marks time. And time wears away, old soldiers. So there is urgency in our message here today about this wonderful initiative called Honor Flight. In 2004, in Washington, D.C., mostly at the urgings of Senator Bob Dole and with donations from millions of Americans, a World War II memorial was finally built to honor these men and women. And today, Honor Flight, a nationwide initiative, is dedicated to getting every last World War II veteran to see it. Make no mistake, however, Honor Flight is not about a World War II memorial. It's not about a trip to Washington, D.C. It's not about concrete monuments. It's about saying thank you.
Thank you. God bless you.
It's about a day of honor, filled with belated, but no less sincere, recognition and appreciation. Our local chapter, Honor Flight Historic Triangle, serves Hampton Roads, southeastern Virginia, and beyond. Thanks to our close proximity to D.C., we can use buses for our honor flight and eliminate the complications and expense of scheduling airlines. It's a full day, a long day, filled with visits to the World War II Memorial and other famous military sites of honor. The trip ends with a visit to the Marine Corps Museum at Quantico for dinner and time to cement newfound friendships. We are told that for many of these veterans, this trip is often the first time they ever really speak of the war, probably because they are surrounded with old comrades. Emotions run high with the pride and dignity that come when receiving sincere, heartfelt appreciation. A daughter of one veteran wrote us this note. At 93, he doesn't get out much anymore. And although his short-term memory is failing, the day after the trip, Sunday, he wore his new Honor Flight windbreaker to church and told everyone the story of his great day. For some of these guys, age overcomes them, and the men they once were become lost. You brought my father back home to us for a short while. Thank you for caring. It goes without saying, they didn't ask for this war. They didn't ask for this fight. More significant, however, they didn't ask for any thank you. But it's time. In fact, we're running out of time. During this week alone, we will lose the opportunity to say thank you to another 8,000 World War II veterans. We need your help. We need to get the word out that this wonderful trip, this day of honor and appreciation, is available to World War II veterans for free. Veterans pay nothing. We also need volunteers to work as guardians on the trips and to help set up the trips. Just as important, we need your financial support. Won't you please consider sponsoring a World War II veteran for our next scheduled trip? Be a corporate sponsor or encourage your club, school, or organization to be a sponsor. Visit our website at honorflighttva.org. For all the liberties we enjoy, for the blanket of freedom we live under, it's time to say thank you to the men and women who understand the sacrifices made for this privilege, who understand freedom doesn't come free.
Quietly you've all turned gray. You did your job, you saved our way. Our life and freedom you preserved.